first thought that I was going to do my top 10 highlighters, but then I realized I don't have 10 that I will know for sure that these are the 10 best I have. I have three that I know would be in a top 10 list, but oh, I'm not used to people seeing the background. That should not be open. That I know would be in the top 10, but yeah. But I'm not tried all my highlighters that much that I want to say that. So I'm going to show you my top three for now that I always know would be awesome if I use them. And it's my go-to if I want to be sure that it's nice. And then I also have seven other highlighters that I know are really good and that I would recommend every day of the week. So yeah, and I will swatch them for you. Some are singles and some are in palettes. How many are in palettes? Huh, five are in palettes, that's appropriate. And five are not in palettes. So I will start by showing you, I think I will show you my top three at the last. So yeah, let's start with the singles. And some of these may not, you know, when you swatch them, they are not that blinding, but when you put them on your face with a brush, it's good. So I have this from Melt. It's their blush light in Shadow Play. It looks white. I think I've had this in a treasure chest video. It's kind of a duochrome highlighter. So it doesn't show up that much, but it's so pretty. It's very finely milled. I don't know if you can even see it, but it has a, is it a green reflect? It looks green, right? I always confuse them, but I think this is the green one. And because I have three others, yeah, and two of them look exactly the same kind of, but this is the green one. Yeah, you can see it there. It's so pretty, and like I said, it's not that glittery blinding one, but it's so pretty on the skin. I love it so much. I look weird, but yeah. And I love the packaging as well. And you have a mirror in here if that is important to you. I think there are mirror in all of these except three, I think. Yeah, never mind. So that is an excellent, and I have not used the other ones as much, but I have liked them equally. So, you know, there is a purple one, I think. Now I'm not going to show you, but there is a gold one called Ghost Light. And then there are a purple pink called Electra. And then I have one, but it's too dark to be a highlighter for me. It's called Fire Fury. Too dark. And then these are also very good, the digital dust ones. This is Stargazer. They only had three from the beginning. The lid is so heavy. I love the print and it stays on. But they have released two new ones that I would really like. But yeah. Oh, no, let's do it later. But these are really good. And I've spent 5 minutes talking about one highlighter. The other one I have is from Becca. I really love Becca highlighters. I have only had a few of them that I don't like. I think it's only one or two that I wasn't my favorite, but then I stopped using them, so maybe I would like them if I use them now. But One of the ones that I use the most is a prismatic amethyst, and it has this special packaging, but you can still get it. I think it's light purple, pinky, whatever. It looks like that. I like pink highlighters. It's also very finely milled. Ooh. It's so pretty. And it's the same, maybe it doesn't look like much, but it's awesome. And I love Becca highlighters. Like that. Then I have one that it's really, it's a bit too dark for me, I think. I don't know why I bought it, because I think I saw that it was too dark, but when I use it, it actually looks good. I just have to be careful not to take too much. But that's the thing with a lot of highlighters that people say are too dark, because I'm really white. I always have the lightest foundations. Do you know the step before white? And I can use Champagne Pop and so on. You just have to do it a bit differently. But yeah, so let's show it. This is Jouer Cosmetics, and this is Skinny Dip. So the packaging looks like this. I also have this in a mini. So you can see it looks really dark, but it's so nice. They have a great highlighter formula as well. I loved all the highlighters I have used. I think I have 12, 4, 6. I have 8 highlighters, or 7, because 2 of them are the same. Look, the mini is so mini. Look, it's so cute. Open. Look, it's so cute. You can see the difference. But this is perfect, you know, who needs more, really? But yeah, so this looks like this. Maybe I should swatch it. So this will look darker, and it's kind of a gold champagne, more champagne, I would say, with gold specks in it. And you will see that I like subtle highlighters, but not as much. And I love glittery highlights and so on, but the favorite I have is the ones, you know, with when it looks almost wet, but not too much. I can't explain it. I'm so bad at explaining. But you can see it looks like it's too dark, but I can use it. Stop bringing out more highlighters. Yeah. And then I have one that I bought recently, or not recently. I think I have it in one of my hauls, but yeah. It's the Physicians Formula one, or one, they have a lot, but this is Pearl Muru Butter Highlighter, so it's the lovely smell as well. I love the smell. It looks like this. I love icy highlighters as well, so let's swatch this. It's so nice. I think this is pink. Yep. It is pink, and as you know, there is no mirror in this one. I think this is the cheapest one I have. Do I all have it? I have only picked out expensive ones. That's awesome. But yeah, you can see it's more icy pink than the one from Becca. Green looks amazing right now. Yeah. Like that. Now we have 3 palettes. I have this, the Anastasia Glow Kit. All the Glow Kits almost are excellent, but they are different types of highlighters in them, so you know. This is the Sweets Kit. It's my absolute favorite. It looks like this. And there is no mirror, so I can show you the right way. I thought there were a mirror in this one. It looks like that. I think some of these shades are in the Sugar Kit. I think Marshmallow and Butterscotch are in that kit. I don't know. But the One I love is Sassy Grape. I don't know if you can get this, but I don't care. I'm showing you the ones I like. And it's also a pink purple one. And I have another one of these kits because I got one and all the shadows, all the highlighters were smashed. So I repressed that and gave it to my mom. So I got a new one myself. And Anastasia Beverly Hills highlighters are excellent to repress. They work fine when you have done that. But yeah, so there it is. It's a bit darker as well. But it's pinky purple. I love it. And I actually have it on my desk because I want to use it more. I hate my eye. It's destroying my makeup. I filmed this makeup, you have probably, no, maybe you haven't seen it. I don't know which video I would put up first, but if you have seen it, then you know. If you haven't seen it, it's coming. Another one I really like is from NARS. It's their Orgasm Infatuation Chic Palette. Oh, I love this design. It's so pretty. And this one has a bronzer, a blush, and a highlighter. And of course it is, you know, these are all the classics. So it's the Laguna bronzer, the Orgasm blush, and the Orgasm highlighting blush powder. But it is a highlighter, but yeah. So it looks like that. And I really like all the three shades in here. I have also had this in a treasure chest, I think. But the highlighter is really good and it's, you know, the classic. Am I showing you a classic? Yeah. We all know how Orgasm looks. And I think I have this in a single. And if I can remember correctly, I think this one is better. Now I'm swatching like crap again. Yeah. But it's a champagne highlighter. It's really nice. And I like to have all the three in this one because then you can take it with you. Ooh. Ah. And the last one before my top three. Did I just take 9 now? I counted them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Now I only have 9. No, I had a glow kit as well. Yeah, I thought I counted right. Yeah, the last one before my top three is from this. I have shown you this before. I love this palette. It's from Too Faced. It's the Sugar Peach Wet and Dry Face and Eye Palette. And it's dirty. It smells lovely. Ugh. All the shades. Have I used all the shades in this one? Yeah, I have. My favorite shade is this. But you know, three of these shades are blushes for me. But the highlighter here. Does it have a name? Yeah, Peach Pearl. It's awesome. And it's more like a light champagne. But this is so pretty. Let's see if you can see it. It's over here. So bad in showing you. And these, I'm showing you, of course, highlighters that looks good on me. But it's not just, you know, the shades, but the formula is really nice. So if you can get highlighters in a shade that matches you, I think you will be pleased as well. There's a big mirror in here. This is a good, maybe I should do a video with my favorite face palettes. Because sometimes I'm really bad at using them because when it comes to single shadows, I use them more if they are in palettes and not in singles, but with face stuff, I much rather use the ones that are, you know, in single compacts. But yeah. Now my three favorite ones, and two are from the same brand, but that's just the way it is. I can't not take one of those because I love them both. I can take the single first. It's from Makeup Geek. The Celestial one. It's the lightest one of the duochromes. I have put stickers on the back of each highlighter because when you open them up, they all look pretty much the same. You can see that these have a pink-purple shift, but when you open up them, pretty much all of them look the same except the really dark ones. So I have put down here what it is, and this is a translucent base with a violet shift. I love this. Makeup Geek makes one of my absolute favorite formulas in highlighters. And I have them all, and I love them. I even have the ones for dark skin tone because I love them and I can use them as eyeshadow. So you can see that. It's so pretty. And then we have this. I have said this in every video I have shown this, but this is the Makeup Geek highlighter palette with Kathleen Lights. It's limited edition, but you know, it's been around forever. And I don't know, maybe you can still get it, I don't know, but it was around for like 3-4 years. And this palette looks super dark when you open it up, but it really isn't. Maybe you can build them up so you know they can fit different skin tones, but I can without a problem use these. Not one of them, I think, as a highlighter. That would be more like a glowy bronzer for me, but it works. And the one shade that I'm obsessed with is this one. Look, it looks really dark, but it really isn't. They are called Sunlight, Starlight, and Nightlight. And Starlight is that one. I have used this so much. Let's watch this. And this looks so nice on. It looks dark, like I said, but I can really make it work because, oops, you don't put that much on your cheek, you know. Pretty highlighters. Look. It's so pretty. Oh, it's so pretty. Now I swatched it in a place you can see, but it's the same shade as. I was just mind blown. And now my absolute favorite highlighter, the best in the world. And I always think about buying an extra, but since it is in a palette, it's, you know, not very cheap. Yeah. And the reason I want to buy duplicate is because, yeah, it's my favorite, and it's also a bit broken. I received it like that. I just have to fix it here, and I don't think it is as deep as the packaging would like you to think it is, but it's from Lime Crime. Their highlight palettes, I have them all, and this is my favorite. It's the Opals one. It's the first one they released. So, you know, the shades in here are called Pink, Gold, Peach. And it looks like this. And it's this shade, and I love the pink one. Let's see. I actually have this in my project pan. But I always have to press it a bit back because it's coming out of the pan. It's so soft. Ooh. But yeah, and I don't think it is this thick because I think I'm going to touch the pan soon. But the peach one is really pretty as well. I like gold highlighters, but they are not my favorite. I go for pink and peach. But yeah, I love this. You can make it like a normal highlighter, or you can build it up like crazy. And this one looks so nice. Maybe I can swatch the peach as well. It's such a pretty peach. I think it's the prettiest peach highlighter I have. Maybe it doesn't show. Oh god, it shows so bad. I would try to zoom you in, but yeah. So these are 10 or 11 really awesome highlighter formulas or highlighters. And that is my favorite. Ow. Now I will be glittery. Or not glittery, because none of these are glittery highlighters. But I will be shimmery. But yeah, so that was 10 highlighters I really like. And also my top 3. So I will maybe do some other video where I show you 10 great highlighters as well. I can show you my I was going to include, oh my god, I'm glittery of this. Yeah, I was going to show you another highlighter, but then I realized that I don't use it as a highlighter, I use it as a blush topper, but it's really pretty as well. It's from Makeup Revolution. It's one of their Vivid Baked Highlighters, and this is in Rose Gold Lights. It looks like this. Oh, I use it as a blush or a blush topper. It's baked. It's so pretty. It's so, and this is cheap, you know. It's so hard to show you. But it's so pretty. I have not tried to use it as just a highlighter, but I love to use it more as a blush or a blush topper. I'm so bad at showing you this. But I can't get the camera closer. I'm sorry. But yeah, let's not make this video longer than it has to be. So, yeah.